guys, welcome back to Review Wednesday. Finally, we are back on track with Review Wednesday and it makes my heart so super happy. Today I'm going to be reviewing something that you guys have been requesting for a while. I'm talking about the Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink, and of course I'm going to be swatching all of the shades for you all. I'm going to have a timestamp right here as to when the swatches will start. So if you want to jump right onto the swatches, you can do that as well. But I'm going to first give you my review and what I think about these liquid lipsticks, and then yeah, the swatches of course. So these liquid lipsticks retail for 650 rupees for about 5 ml of product. And this is what the packaging looks like. It comes in a color-coded packaging, but this is not transparent. This is like actual opaque plastic. So yeah, and the cap is white, and as soon as you open it up, you have the wand right there. The wand is like a teardrop wand, but it does have a hole in between which holds a lot of product. So when you're applying it, like one dip is almost enough to cover the entire lip, which is a nice thing. Next up, talking about the texture. Now these say that they're super matte inks. They're not super matte, like they still have slight satin to them, like a very slight satin. They're not like matte. They're not like liquid lipsticks. First of all, I thought when they said matte ink, somehow in my brain I've connected them to like the Peri Para inks, like very watery, very liquidy, but they're not extremely watery or liquidy. They're more creamier than I thought they would be or should be. So they're on a creamier side, so they have slight satin to them, a very slight satin. They look pretty matte, but you know, the one who's applied it, they know that it's not like fully matte. And that you can also prove by the transfer test, because these do transfer. These are not transfer proof. So anything that you will touch or kiss with your lips, it will transfer onto that. Now these claim that they stay on your lips for about 16 hours, which I think they should remove the 1-6 maximum. After 5 hours of wear, this does start to fade away, and it leaves you actually with a butthole lip. It does not fade away completely from the lips, leaving like a nice tint behind, which I like, but it gives you a butthole lip, which I freaking hate. Now coming to the drying down aspect, I feel like even though these aren't completely matte, they're slightly on the drier side. So you have to ensure that you moisturize your lips nicely before you apply this. Now these come in about 10 shades in India, and then I like the color selection. They're not just pinks and reds. They also have like a couple of nudes and orange and purple and a brown, which is something I love. But I felt like there was slight discrepancy in the colors. Like some of the colors were slightly patchy while the others weren't so patchy. So I really could not make up my mind, like especially the orange color. It is pretty patchy, so you have to work it and you have to finesse it in your lips. And even the color Loyalist, or the lightest color, was slightly patchy on me. I did, however, neutralize my lips before every lip color. So I applied a nice layer of concealer before going on with this. But I still felt like Loyalist was slightly patchy on me. So I had to completely finesse it in and make sure that it just like nicely blended in. Now I don't know why, but it slightly sticks together on your lips. So when you do like this, right, your lips tend to stick together. I don't know why does that happen, even though this is like a matte liquid lipstick, but it does tend to stick together like a gloss, which is something I'm not a fan of. Then also something that I kind of noticed was these liquid lipsticks are pretty stringy, so when you take the wand out, that you are left with a string like this, and it dropped on my clothes, and that's exactly why this is an issue. A lot of people will be like, why is that an issue? But if you are using them for the first time and you just like carelessly open them up like normally, you can ruin your clothes. I've done this with me with concealer. I've had a lot of concealer mishaps happen with me, so I know I'm very careful with how I open my products, and I lay down a towel on me so that if anything drops, it drops onto the towel. But products like these, which are pretty stringy, they can ruin your clothes, so please be careful with that. Now let's move on to the swatches, and then I will give you my final thoughts on these lipsticks. So those were all of the shades. Now let's just sum up all of the pros and the cons so that you guys can make your own decision. So pro number one, Maybelline is easily available throughout India. Pro number two, the price is semi-affordable. I wouldn't call it super, super, super affordable, but it is kind of on the affordable side. Pro number three, I like the packaging. It's very pretty. Pro number four is the color range. I really like the color range. It has a color for everyone and every mood, which is something I love. There are not only pinks and reds, but as I said, there are a different couple of colors in there as well. Now, moving on to the cons. Con number one, I'm not a very big fan of the texture. Although it's not supremely matte, it still feels slightly drying down. Con number two, it is not transfer proof. It does transfer on. Con number three, I'm not a very big fan of the stringy effect of the lipstick. Con number four, it kind of makes my mouth sticky, which I don't really like. And con number five would be the fact it does not stay on for 16 hours as claimed, but it wears off after like 5-6 hours of wear, and it does leave you with butthole lips. So yeah, we have 4 against 5. I think this is the first time in the history of Review Wednesday that we have such a situation going on. I don't really know what I feel about these lipsticks. I feel like there's so many better lipsticks available in the same or lesser price range. I don't see the point of spending 650 rupees on these liquid lipsticks. It's not like you can't find these colors in other ranges, although I like the color range, but I'm pretty sure you will find these colors in so many lipstick ranges. And I really don't see the point of more liquid lipsticks. Like, we're done, we're saturated, we are like full to the brim with liquid lipsticks. So I feel like you can skip these, you can easily skip these. There is no particular need, like, you know, a dire need of these in your lives. You can get better liquid lipsticks, and that is what I think about these. I love Maybelline, I love all of their products, like mostly all of their products, but these ones sadly were a dud for me. I wouldn't recommend them to you. I wouldn't be like, you have to go out and buy them right now, because there is no need, as I said. I will try to link below some other channels with their reviews and their swatches, so that you can see the colors on different skin tones as well, and their viewpoint as well. Of course, everyone's viewpoint is different. I can only give you my own experience with these liquid lipsticks, which I hope will stand true for you as well. So yeah, with that, we complete Review Wednesday. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and if you did, then don't forget to comment and subscribe. It would mean a lot to me. Also, let me know which other product you guys would like to see next week on Review Wednesday down below, and we'll get it on board. And yeah, as I said, this is gonna be it. I love you all so much. Mwah. Bye.